is Lee Thomas, the Emmy Award-winning anchor and entertainment reporter for WJBK in Detroit. He suffers from, I guess you'd call it a disease, from vitiligo. He's got a new book out called Turning White, a memoir of change. There you see its cover. What is vitiligo?
It's a pigment disorder or disease where your body actually starts to attack the pigment cells in your skin. And it's beyond turning white, Larry. You actually are void of color. The simply titled the book was Turning White, but it's void of color. I'm pigmentless in parts of my skin. For lighter skinned people, it's not as noticeable, but for darker skinned people, it's
so it can happen to Caucasians.
It can happen to anyone, any age, usually between 25 and 45, but I've seen people as young as 3, 6, 7 who
male
have the disease.
Male
and female, yep.
During the first break, Lee is going to take some wipes here, and he is he's makeup now. He's in this kind of odd. He's being made up to look like he really looks in real life. In other words, this is him. He is a black individual.
Right.
When he does the wipes, we'll see how he... Well, I tell you what. He wasn't always like this. Let's take a look at what Lee goes through on a typical day at the station. Watch.
All right, so what I usually do is I come in and I have to put the stuff on and prepare. Then I have two different kinds of makeup that I use, Glam and Pow. So I usually start with this. I'm almost out.
The transformation begins.
The reason I start using two different colors is because men's beards are usually darker, especially African-American men, their beard line is usually darker, so it looks more natural that way. I have to do my ears. You can definitely see them on camera. So Larry, this is it. I've finished putting on all my makeup, and I think I've gotten everything.
Take it off the first break and reverse it. Is it weird to make yourself up to look like you really are?
No. At this point, I'm very comfortable putting on the makeup, and it's really for other people because I know what people, when they see me without makeup, it's hard for them to pay attention to what I'm saying. A lot of times they're staring at my ear or my neck or not really paying attention to my words. And when you're on camera, when you're on television or on the news like what I do, I have a great time being there, but I know it's all about the information and not about me, so I try to do as much as I can to focus on the information and not myself.
Lee, is there anything dangerous in this, in that, for example, supposing you lived a whole life made up?
No. The vitiligo takes your pigment away, and the thing that happens from that, it's not contagious, it's not life-threatening, but I can get a bad sunburn, which is brand new for me, because as an African-American, I never had to deal with a sunburn, Larry. So the first time I got sunburned was on my arm, and I didn't know what it was. I had to ask somebody what's going on. My arm's red, and it itches. So
put your hands up toward the camera.
Sure, so where can you guys get
Let's
that?
Get the full camera on, okay, guys? Sure. Do away with the mirror.
There
Thanks.
You go.
We're crazy
yeah,
with
you can
mirrors.
See the contrast. Yeah. Put both of them up. There you go. So you can see it's completely gone at this point. You can see a little bit of pigment starting right in some of these areas. We can see on my wrist. That's where the pigment starts to come back.
Does it come back?
Well, it's possible. You know, I know the possibility is there. I've talked to people who have regained pigment, and 80% of the people that have this disease respond to treatment in some fashion. And I have responded to treatment before, but as soon as I stopped the treatment, and it was standing in a light booth after putting cream on my body, as soon as I stopped, within weeks, it started to fade again.
What did you notice first?
I first got it on my scalp, and then... ironically, I got it on my left hand. I had a few spots on the back of my head. And you can see almost through my hairline that
yeah,
you can see
it.
Pigment sure. is gone. Spots on my scalp, both sides, and then on my left hand. So when the most famous gloved one put on his one glove, he has vitiligo as well. I understand why, because I got it on my left hand, and I started to wear one glove when I would do a report.
Does Michael Jackson refer to himself as having vitiligo?
He does. He said it to Oprah Winfrey. He said it to Martin Bashir, a British journalist. He does have vitiligo, and I could not imagine. There's only a few hundred thousand people that watch me in Detroit, but being the most famous person on the planet and having this disease, when you look one way on an album cover, but when you're at home, you look like the cover of my book there. It must have been tough to deal with, to have hundreds of millions of people looking at you and having to keep that secret.
Was it scary the first time you looked at the scalp and the wrist?
When it got on my face, I completely freaked out. I thought I was going to lose my job, and my job is my livelihood. I worked my way through college to be able to do what I love. I love television. It's much respect to be sitting across from you, by the way, my man. But I worked my way through college and paid for it myself to get there, Larry. And when my face started changing, I really thought it was the end. And I had to take a walk. I was working in New York at the time. I had to walk down to the park and just clear my head and regain a perspective on life, because I really thought that things were over.
When you go on an airplane, are you made up, or do you?
No, when I'm traveling.
Are you stared at?
All the time. I was getting gas the other day, and you know how you can see through the pump when you're pumping gas. A lady on the other side stopped, and she goes, "What's wrong with you?" And I go, "Besides the gas prices, I'm good. Nothing's wrong with me." But it took me a while to get there. There were times before when I would be on an elevator and someone scooted away from me and tried not to make eye contact with me because they didn't know what it was. You know, it's ignorance, not mean or malicious ignorance. It's just they don't know what it is. And hopefully, you know, with the book and with what I'm doing, people will know. Because it all started with a kid. A kid called me and asked me to tell my story so that people will treat him differently. I told him yes, and I've been telling the story ever since on television in book form. But I did not know so many people didn't know about this disease.
Lee Thomas, when we come back, we'll see Lee's transformation. You will witness what he lives with every day without his mask of makeup. He's starting already.
Yep.
The real Lee Thomas, next. We're back on Larry King Live. The book is Turning White, A Memoir of Change. The author is Lee Thomas, the Emmy Award-winning anchor from WJBK in Detroit. He has now put on the wipes and put the wipes on his face and ears and neck, and this is how he looks. When this started, you didn't tell your employers, right? How did you hide it? With makeup?
Initially, yeah, I covered it with makeup, but it wasn't this bad. In the book, you see a progression, and it started off with small little spots that were easier to cover, but as it progressed, I was put in the position to have to do something. I could keep trying to hide it, and it was difficult to hide it on my hands, or I could just say, look, this is what's happening. I don't know what's going to happen, but as I continue to deal with this, I might want to stop being on TV at some point. And I took that to my boss, and they've been nothing but supportive at my job in Detroit.
They want you to stay on.
They said, whatever you decide is fine with them. We're behind you 110%. And they've been great at WJBK from day one. And they've definitely said, we want you to stay, but whatever you feel comfortable doing is what we want you to do.
How about the family?
My family, it's like they don't even see it. And I love them for
Who's
that.
Who's in the family?
I have... two sisters, three brothers, bunch of nieces and nephews. I'm not married yet. I have a girlfriend, and she's the same way.
She's black or white?
She's a black woman, yeah. She's a black woman, and she has nothing but love for me. I actually text her before the show to say, hey, they want me to take my makeup off. What do you think? She says, I love you without the makeup, but you do what you feel comfortable doing. So she actually prefers me without the makeup on, and hey, I love her for that.